Sometimes what makes an exam tough is not just the questions on the paper, but how many other students you are competing against. The exam that Chinese students take to gain entrance into university was last year sat by over 10 million students. That exam is known as the Gaokao, and it's a huge deal. Students spend years preparing for the exam, often with very intense study schedules and hours of extra coaching outside of school. The exam is sat once per year in June, and that day is taken very seriously. Traffic is diverted away from exam halls and police patrol to keep the streets quiet. There are ambulances waiting outside just in case of a nervous collapse. Parents will gather to pick up their children afterwards with flowers to celebrate the fact that it's over. It is such high stakes because the exam will give students a three-digit number, which will often be the sole determinant of their acceptance into university. The prestigious Tier 1 universities are highly sought after, as they may offer greater employment opportunities once graduated, but their acceptance rate may be as low as 1 in 50,000 students. For many students, doing well on the Gaokao may be a ticket to a better life. I have a copy of the 2020 exam here, and I'll go through a few of the questions just to show you what it is like. The exam consists of compulsory sections on Chinese, math, and a foreign language, often English, and electives from physics, chemistry, biology, or history, geography, or politics. And it takes 9 hours over a couple of days. Some of the most notorious questions are the essays, and I've translated a few of them here. This one is pretty relevant, and it's all about coronavirus. They say that in the face of the outbreak, they have adopted prevention and control measures, that people are staying at home, venues are closed, and there is a safe 1 meter between people. They talk about the role of volunteers, medical experts, workers and teachers, and even journalists in fighting the virus. Then the question says, please synthesize the above materials and write an article with the theme of distance and connection in the epidemic. And they are to write an essay of at least 800 words on this topic. It seems that current affairs or current politics are often essay questions, but so are some poetic and more unusual sounding ideas. This one, for example, was so lovely even after passing through Google Translate that I wanted to share it with you. People use their eyes to see others and the world, but they cannot directly see themselves as a whole. Therefore, in the journey of life, we need to look for all kinds of mirrors, constantly draw self-portraits to examine ourselves, and try to answer, what kind of person am I? What kind of life do I want to live? And what can I do? How to live more meaningfully, and other important issues. The question asks you to write an essay, as if you are writing a letter to freshmen who are about to enroll in the first year of high school, on this theme of being able to perceive yourself. Challenging, but a pretty interesting one. Since this is a physics and maths channel, I'll also take a look at those questions. This is one of the 2020 math papers in Chinese. Even just from looking at the symbols and pictures, you might be able to tell there are quite a few word problems, as well as a lot of geometry, logic, a little bit of calculus, some complex numbers, and some probability and statistics. I Google translated question 5 to see that it says, if the circle passing the point 2,1 is tangent to the two coordinate axes, the distance from the center of the circle to the straight line 2x minus y minus 3 equals 0 is what? This is my interpretation of what that looks like, a circle that passes through the point 2,1 and for which both the axes are tangent. We want to find the distance from the center of the circle, which would be at 1,1, to this straight line, and we'll take that to mean the shortest distance, which will meet the line at a perpendicular angle. We'll want to find the equation of this line, and to do that we'll use the formula y minus y1 is equal to mx minus x1. M, or the gradient of this line, will be the opposite reciprocal of the line that we already know, and that gradient is 2, so the gradient of our line will be minus 1/2. Substituting 1s for y1 and x1, we'll get the equation to be y is equal to minus 1/2 x plus 3/2. The line we already know could be rewritten as y is equal to 2x minus 3. So we can set these two equations equal to each other. Doing that will give us the point where they intersect. Those coordinates are x equals 9/5 and y equals 3/5. Now we just want to find the distance between these two known points. To do that, we will use the distance formula, which is the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. Putting our coordinates into there and doing a bit of rearranging, we'd find that the correct answer is B. 2/5/5. I think that the math involved here is reasonable to expect on entrance exams in a lot of countries. There are quite a few steps to this one though, so it's a little tricky, but I think it's worth remembering that this exam is not so much a certification or a test that you have learned what you've been taught at school. Instead, this is a ranking system. It doesn't really matter that you know how to do all the math steps to solve this problem and you pull it all off without making a mistake. It matters that you can get through the entire exam making as few mistakes as possible in order to rank high among the other students. It doesn't really matter how much you know, it matters how much everyone else knows as well. Moving on to physics, this is the 2020 Beijing paper. And the whole thing has been Google translated. There is a bit of atomic physics on the first page, thermodynamics, waves, some electromagnetism, including number 8, where they've got a picture of a small magnetic needle hanging near a negatively charged rubber disc. The disc rotates at high speed around the central axis, and the small magnetic needle deflects. You're then asked to determine what's going on. There's electronics, a question about molecular forces, friction, and one about the conservation of momentum and energy. Question 14 is asking about a basketball that is dropped from a height but is given a bit of spin, and instead of falling straight down, it deviates from the vertical and moves in a curve. The second part of this physics exam seems to be more about some experimental techniques. There are some classic questions about experimental design and following the scientific method. The first section was multi-choice, but this section requires written answers. There are 20 questions in here, but a lot of them have multiple parts and some are pretty lengthy. For this physics paper I've shown, you would get 90 minutes. So it is still a race against the clock. In conclusion, as one would expect, this is a difficult exam, but I don't think that learning the content matter is really that far out of reach for most students. In fact, it is really dealing with the insane competitiveness that comes with trying to get all these points without making mistakes, because even a tiny mistake could see your ranking plummet. Best wishes for anyone who is perhaps preparing for this exam or an exam like it coming up in 2021. One day, I hope you too will be able to look at exams just for fun. I do have a whole series looking at exams across the world, so check out some of those videos in the playlist at the end. Thanks as always to my Patreon supporters for making these videos possible, including a special shout out to today's Patron Cats of the Day, Strega and Luna. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.